Adding a checkbox to an Excel spreadsheet is a little more complicated than putting an X in a cell, but it's also a little magic, and I'll show you how it works. So I know you're thinking, a checkbox, how complicated could this be? But actually, checkboxes and other objects you can put into Excel start treating your spreadsheet like a database. And that's part of the magic of Excel, is that it's not just a place where you put in numbers and add and divide them and stuff like that. It can be a database, and it can act on the data you put in there and help you make decisions in these cool ways. So I'm going to show you how checkboxes work that way. So here I've set up a very simple spreadsheet. I have three foster kittens, and I'm tracking how well they're learning to play with different toys. Here's the feather toy, and what I'm doing is I'm counting how often they catch the feather, but if they catch it in midair, they get extra points. So here I've set up a checkbox for Mittens to see when he's catching it in midair. At the moment, he hasn't, because he's a lazy ass, but say that he gets off his butt and catches the feather in midair. All I have to do is click this checkbox, and you see that the cell underneath it changed from false, didn't catch it midair, to true, yes, he did. And suddenly, these bonus points show underneath. He gets 3 bonus points every time he catches it in midair, and then his total points go up by 4. Now, think about this. All I did was turn this checkbox on or off, and 3 things happened underneath it. That is what is magic about the checkbox tool and all these other objects that you can use in Excel. So now we're going to set up a checkbox for my second kitten, Socks. And the first thing we have to do is make sure that you have the developer menu activated on Excel. Go to File, Options, Customize Ribbon, and over on the right, you see all the different menus you can have in Excel. Go down and you see Developer is not checked, so I'm going to check it, click OK, and now the Developer tab is showing at the top of Excel. That's great, I'm going to click it. Click Insert, and this box comes up with all these form controls and ActiveX controls. This is like Wonderland for me, but we're only going to do checkbox today, so I'm going to click checkbox, and then go down to the cell where I want it, click there, and there it is. Now, this checkbox has corner handles. This is how you move the checkbox around in your spreadsheet. Remember, this is not like regular Excel data in the cell. You're actually kind of moving it around on top of the spreadsheet. So I'm going to do a couple of things here. I'm going to right-click inside here and edit the text, because I don't need this text next to the checkbox. Now I'm going to right-click within the corner handles again and go to Format Control. And here you set up some basic settings for the checkbox, like what default value do you want for it? Do you want it to be unchecked by default, checked by default, or mixed, which means it's kind of grayed out? And I want it unchecked by default, so I'm going to keep it that way. And then I'm going to go down to cell link, and this is where the magic starts happening. If you put a cell link in here, that cell will reflect the status of the checkbox. So I want my cell status to be right in the cell below it. So I'm going to click on that cell. The cell link will show there. I click OK. Doesn't look like anything yet though, but watch this. I click on the checkbox and true shows up. I unclick it and false shows up. The checkbox is a very basic true-false on-off sort of data object. And I could just sit here all day on a really boring day and just watch this go true-false, true-false. But that's what's so cool about how data entry works in Excel, because now that I have this true-false setup, I can set up a formula so that when I check that box or uncheck it, Socks will or won't get his midair points for catching that feather. So we're going to show how that works. We're going to write a formula here. I'm going to type if cell C6, that's where it says false, equals true, then Socks will get 3 points, and if it doesn't equal true, he'll get 0 points. So right now it says false, he gets 0 points, but if I click that he does catch it in midair, he gets 3 points. So look at that. Now the checkbox is turning the cell below it into true or false, and it's also causing the bonus midair points to show up as either 0 or 3. Now I want to add the feather points and the bonus points to get Socks' total score for playtime. So I'm going to write another formula where I add up his playtime points and his bonus points. And now we have his total of 5 points. And again, this is all happening because of this checkbox. If I make this false, all the points change. If I make it true, they all change again. So now you've seen how objects like checkboxes can add a little magic to your Excel spreadsheet. And if you have any other questions about Excel, just email us at answer@pcworld.com.